sweet as apple juice. Talking trophies, I didn't grab if you can't match this attitude. I wear my heart on my sleeve, please. I move like the wind, can't catch this breeze, freeze. Stop you in your tracks, it's not no preseason. We seeking W's like Tupac used to throw up. Forget it, might as well forfeit your team, shouldn't even show up. What you wanna be when you grow up? They used to ask me. Naturally, I chose an athlete. Competition never matched me. We ain't go together like camouflage and polka dots. Focus on your position, just know your spot. Sure, don't stop. It's a long season. They planning on winning for the wrong reasons. Trying to get my number retired. Can't let these frauds beat us. I figured out the recipe. Never let opponents get the best of me. I'm focused on my legacy.
Big chips, man, I need that. Hustle hard on the job, you can see that. On my head is real good, we don't need your feedback. They clear the way with my crew coming through. What I do? Lace up the shoes, chase W's. What I do? Lace up the shoes, chase W's. Now what I do? Lace up the shoes, chase W's. Yeah, beats, leave it in the street, case on the news.
The throne, I ain't a king, not a pawn. Hop on a jet, cross the globe. I guess the world is my home, and there's so many milkers burning my dome, and like turbulent air, I'm switching these flows. If you look at my neck, boy, I'm letting it snow. I'm sturdy as hell, it's a vessel alone. They showing me love in my city, gangs and hippies. Women like they can know what I'm about. I'm not the stereotypes, they do not fit me. I'm bigger than life, give everyone jobs. I'm not a guard, the heart with a squad. I'm playing my part, but them LeBron. Wings of the team, I feel Jackson and hard. The homie calling from a cell, a couple of homies be making it. I just want all of them dudes to do well. Not worried about taking a couple of L's. Don't sin for me, just win for me. Don't kill for me, just live for me. Keep it real for me, we eat together, leave the bill for me like.
Hand on my heart, I give it all I got. Water walk inside the tarp, take it higher, that's a god. Hand on my heart, no, I give it all I got. Water walk, top to top, take it higher, that's a god. Never stopping, that's a must. Always winning, never lost. GPS, I never lost. GPS, I never lost. Like,
who do it better than me, yeah? Vision on 2020, yeah. BBS, Club D, yeah. Determination, laser focus. Banging on they door, they taking notice. Taking notice, taking notice. Determination, laser focus. Banging on they door, they taking notice.
A lot of money, why are you mad like that?
Like that.
Ooh, I'm in my new bag, my bad. You ain't get too bad, my bad.
Yeah.
First of the month, I'ma run it back.
Ay.
Same day, why I'ma run it back?
Yeah.
Friday, payday, run it back.
Ay.
Run it back, run it back, run it back.
Ooh. 48 yards, I run it back.
Ay.
I cop a car, I run it back.
Yeah.
Go on your then run it back.
Run it back, run it back, run it back.
Hello?
That's the jet calling.
Dunk it. Let me click over. Quick
to let my jack talk it.
Ooh, Pac-Man, that's the way my neck talking.
Right,
I ain't never coming back the way the stress.
You don't make no clap back when you backpack, my bad, but I'm past that. With an ass back, that's cash. When the money fall, I'ma slap that. Clap when the money go, you don't slap. That's facts. If the money low, I'ma grab raw man. When it come back, I'ma give back my bad. When the check hit, the direct hit, I'm glad. When the check missed, the direct hit, I'm sad. Like,
who's that knocking at my window?
My window.
They say that it's the money, I'm like tenfold.
Over and out.
That's gonna make you fuck like a limbo. She say she not a, she an.
Ay.
Ooh, why you do that like that?
Like that?
It's a lot of money. Why are you mad like that?
Like that?
Ooh, I'm in my new bag, my bad.
My bad.
You ain't get too bad, my bad.
Yeah.
First of the month, I'ma run it back.
Ay.
Same day, why I'ma run it back?
Yeah.
Friday, payday, run it back.
Ay.
Run it back, run it back, run it back.
Ooh.
48 yards, I run it back.
Ay.
I cop a car, I run it back.
Yeah.
Go on your then run it back.
Run it back,
going
run it back,
big,
run it back.
Going big. Everywhere I go, they know the click.
Coach, there will be time for reflection, certainly as the season goes on, but for what might be the final time in the East Bay, it is opening night of the NFL season here in Oakland, California. The pregame festivities here in Oakland have to be seen to be believed. This crowd in silver and black, they are fired up as their Raiders get set to face off with the Denver Broncos. Here's the former Auburn kicker, Daniel Carlson, to get this one started. And we are underway on a Monday night. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Rookie, it's Philip Lindsay. He'll wind up getting a yard on the game's first play. It's second down. Well, unless there's a postseason meeting later in the year, this is most likely the final time that the Broncos and Raiders will play in Oakland. Of course, so much history between the two since their inaugural season in the AFL back in 1960. Broncos and Raiders have been locked together in the same division, facing off twice a season. And this rivalry also stands as the most common pairing for Monday night games like we have here, 18 times, the most of any two teams. A throw over the middle, taken in. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Broncos first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Denver has the first down, the play going for 15 yards.
Well, that play looks familiar because we saw them working on it in practice this week. And for a lineman trying to block on this play, they love when they get the defense moving in one direction. And when they try and change directions, it's a lot easier to pick them up and ward them off.
So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 49-yard line. A shotgun snap for Luck. This one caught by Delanie Walker. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. That one goes for 24 yards.
Well, it's looking sharp right from the get-go here. Tough division. They needed this kind of a start. But I think this is part of where scripting comes in. We always hear about the scripting of plays, how they're going to be called. Everyone dress rehearses their script, and right now they're following it to a T.
And for that opening drive, so part of the script still to come, right, Parker?
Yeah, no doubt about it. We've got a ways to go with that, but you can tell that they worked on the script the entire week in practice, and it's paying off for them. Well, we saw them there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
On second down, a run with Lindsay. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. It'll be a gain of 5, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now it's third down.
Hey, world! 44th of Mike, 44th of Mike. Check. Here we go. Bump the mic.
From the gun, here's Love. And he's got his man on the out route. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. How about the start throwing the football? 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when you talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard, not necessarily accurately. In this case, though, he's honing in on his targets, and he's delivering.
Yeah, the opening script, however, they drew it up for this first drive going to plan so far. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. That'll wind up going for a loss of 4. And that'll bring up a second and goal. Here's Locke. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
Now Locke on third and goal. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Once you get into the red zone and the safeties have less ground to cover, you'd better be quick with your delivery. Not much space to get a ball in there.
Yeah, when that field shrinks with those safeties, it's almost like there's a couple extra defenders out there, right?
It certainly is. They end up taking up extra space just because there's not enough space for receivers to run through.
Well, all offseason, probably a lot of thought goes into that first drive of week one. They didn't get the touchdown, but at least they got something.
And what I like about it is that they didn't overthink it, because you're exactly right. A lot goes into the offseason, the preseason, to get to that first drive of the regular season. They went right downfield, mission accomplished, points on the board.
Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. This is Josh Jacobs, the Alabama man, with his first NFL carry. They'll only get a couple up to about the 30.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you, and sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the play, as we just saw there.
We saw a great example of perseverance right there on that play.
Got to be careful. They might want to throw one over his head as this game progresses.
45, Mike, 45. Exit.
From the 30 on second down, Carr got a man open. It's Darren Waller. The pickup goes for 16 and a Raider first down. Second year in Oakland for Waller after being signed off the Ravens practice squad, but only 6 catches, 75 yards a season ago. Then he got a lot of hype in the offseason following OTAs. Their offensive coordinator saying, you know, Darren, you have that position. Coach Gruden went as far as to say, Darren, you have the chance of a lifetime here. Well, now it's time for Darren Waller to go out there and prove it. A minimal gain as we tick down inside of a minute remaining in the opening quarter. So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. On second down, Jacobs. And he's got it across midfield and into Denver territory.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Right now,
185. I got you. 7:34.
Carr with a play fake to Jacobs. Escaping the pressure right. He can run for it, and he will. When in doubt, do it yourself as he keeps it for 3 and a first down.
And a Raider first down. First and 10 at the 43-yard line.
Second quarter from Oakland, the homestanding Raiders with the football here as they've got it with a first and 10. 3-0 after 1 on EA Sports. Here's Jacobs on first and 10. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3.
That's one of the reasons you like the blitz, even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
At the Broncos 40-yard line.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Carr gives to Rashard. They'll wind up getting four down to the 36.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number seven on third and two.
Hey, wait on two. 45. Mike, 45.
From the gun, it's Carr. Quick hitter here, it's complete. A pickup of 10, and it's enough for an Oakland first down. And a nice start there to the aerial attack to pick up the first.
And I think preseason is officially over now. Getting into the groove of the regular season, that's a great way to get started. First drive of the season, what a nice completion.
They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of five or six.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
93. Express.
Check my 45. There it comes.
On second down and four. Carr. Got his man. That's Tyrell Williams. And he will reach the five-yard line before going out of bounds. They've got another first down. The Raider passing game clicking on all cylinders right now. Here's Jacobs. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the five down to the three. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
So the ball position now at the three. Here's second and goal. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. From 3 yards out, and the Raiders have taken the lead. That's one of those long drives where not only do you score, but you really tire out the defense, too.
That's a great point, because now they've been on the field for a long time. Them going to the bench, trying to make adjustments, trying to figure things out, but they'll do so fatigued.
Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. This will be taken in at the one. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They finished off their opening drive of the campaign with a field goal on the last drive. Now they'll search for a touchdown here on this go-around. First and 10. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 17 yards for the Broncos there as they've got themselves a first down. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. And this is caught. A spectacular one-handed grab there. That throw good for four. It's second down.
Gotta love the catch. I think you gotta love the gloves as well.
Yeah, these one-handed catches, that was great, and they're fun. They've become a little more ho-hum, aren't they?
Yeah, they really are. And I know that it sounds like we're taking credit away from the guys, and we don't mean that at all. They really work hard on this one-handed catch thing. But I think the gloves have to be helping in a big way.
And he's going to have this down deep into Oakland territory. It's a big play there for the Broncos. 41 yards. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. And we remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll hand things off to the coach, Jonathan Coachman, in Orlando. He'll have a look back at a very intriguing opening weekend in the NFL. To throw is locked. And this is caught by Sutton. Touchdown, Broncos. Cortland Sutton there to make the grab. And the Broncos have retaken the lead. McManus's point after is good. And the lead is now 10-7. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Oakland offense about ready to start this next drive. They were successful last time finding the end zone on their opening drive of the season. And they'll get another shot here with a first and 10. Here's Carr to throw. Looking left side, he's got it. Complete. That one good for 13 and a Raider first down. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
Carl come up here with a first and 10, and he's completed all seven of his passes thus far. On the ground, Richard. The all-pro Von Miller there on the tackle.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and 6.
You're mine. Check nickel, nickel, nickel. Check, 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 check.
Carr. And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. Von Miller doing what he does best with a sack. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Carr and the Raiders following the sack, looking up at a third and long. Working from the gun, it's Carr. He's airing it out for Williams. That's caught inside the 20. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. On fourth down, A.J. Cole comes on to punt. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. A little under 30 seconds to go. We'll see how they play it here on first and 10. Out of the gun. Luck. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Maurice Hurst busting through to get him for a loss of 6. Now the Broncos going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack.
He's checking, he's checking, he's checking.
Back to throw, Luck.
Well, that's the second time he's been sacked so far in the first half. And if they have designs on having a big year, on going anywhere, they've got to find a way to keep him upright so they can throw the football.
After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
No run call here. They'll look to throw instead. A 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Prince Amukamara. Now after the INT, it's Carr. And this is caught at the 8. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. That gain of 15 gets him on the doorstep, first and goal. So it's first and goal and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break.
Hey, hey, hey. High 7.
Shotgun now for Carr. Drops this off to Richard. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So with two ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit from the right hash, and this one just a chipper. Carlson able to put this one through. So we have reached halftime here in the final game of opening weekend 2019. As we send you cross-country to Orlando, Jonathan Coachman is there and has our EA Sports Halftime Report. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. Well, the first play of the drive lost four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. Carr gonna throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
On third and long, it's Carr. Got a man, it's complete. Williams. Call that a very strong gain of 24. On first down, it's Jacobs. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. A pickup of 10, and it's enough for an Oakland first down. So a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 49-yard line. On first down, they go with Jacobs again. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. A Raider first down, 17 yards.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
No gain there on the completion, second and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained. So they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Throwing on second down. Carr completes it to Aguilar. And he'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7. Seventh play of the drive now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. From the gun, Carr. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Carr will come up here with a 1st and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. Richard. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down.
That's a strong pickup right there on 1st down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
They go back to the ground, this time Jacobs. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. That's now consecutive 5-yard carries to pick up the 1st down. They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And he's over the line and in for a Raider touchdown. Josh Jacobs with his first career touchdown in his first career game as his guys are able to regain the lead. X extra point by Carlson, up and good. And that makes it a 17-10 score. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. This will be taken in at the one. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Now it looks like we've got a Bronco that's banged up on the play. Huh, hate to see this. Week one of the season. We'll be back. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down 7 following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
And they need to take a good, relaxing, deep breath, don't you think? Because right now they might start to feel like they've got to play catch-up here and start matching them point for point. But it's still too early to get there. They can still run their offense. Plenty of time to get back in this game.
Let's go.
On first down, it's long. And Walker has it. That one good for 13 and a Denver first down.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. He's got a first down and more inside the 30 and down to the 29-yard line. That one good for 13 and a Denver first down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Here's second and 10 now from the 29.
Mike 4-2.
Again, Love. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And down inside the 15 he goes. Back now in the East Bay. It's the Broncos trailing, but they do have possession of the football as we begin quarter number 4. On first and 10, it's Lindsey. And effective running here. He'll take it down inside the 10. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
They'll keep it on the ground. This time it's Gordon. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves him with a 3rd and 3.
Watching that play unfold and watching him complete it brought back memories of doing all those pursuit drills to make sure you don't over-pursue and let a guy get a cutback lane on you. He did that very well.
You praised him on tape yesterday for the angles that he takes to the ball. Took a great angle right there. Oh, no, he lost the football.
On plays like this, when the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
So an interesting call there to take the 3. And I guess they're thinking that their hands were tied. But, you know, fourth quarter, that field goal might not help them that much in the end.
Yeah, eventually they're going to need the touchdown. The thinking must have been, they didn't feel confident about picking it up there, hoping maybe on defense they can get better field position, get a turnover, get a better play, and then they'll have a chance to attack the end zone.
The Oakland offense about ready to start this next drive. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a one-score game. And you hear a lot about two-minute offense and four-minute offense. Obviously, the four-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Yeah, really what the four-minute offense is you're just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays, But it has to be plays that kicks first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
But certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure that you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs. Keep possession of the football.
Once again, it's Jacobs. And he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. To throw his car. Flushed out right. He may try and run for this. He opted to go with a scramble, gets 2 yards, and now it's fourth.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
Check 43.
Express.
Motion.
They go with Jacobs.
Here we go.
Well, they didn't accomplish their goal. They didn't get a stop there, gave up another first down. They have all three timeouts in their pocket. I think defensively, you've got to start thinking about using them here.
I was just going to ask you, at what point you think now's the go time?
I think now's the go time. I don't think you sit back and wait, because they can take a lot of time off the clock between plays and run 3 to 4 and really put you in a stressful spot.
Express, 6:37.
They'll begin on the ground with Jacobs. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time. And that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage. Use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't they?
Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The sack by Michael Bennett, the native of tiny Independence, Louisiana. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Raider football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And now a high kick here as he'll try to hang it up there. That'll be a 43-yard punt, just a single yard on the return. And the Broncos take over, first down and 10. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
A gain of 32 that time. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. Luck now to throw. Eluding the pressure right. He's going to let it fly. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. LaMarcus Joyner with a pick.
And that one, Oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the two-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw, and it'll wind up being intercepted.
On the ground, it's Jacobs to start the drive, and he will forge his way forward only up to the two-yard line. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. This is Richard. And he's able to get this up just shy of the 15. That one will go as a gain of 11. Raiders having a first down as well.
That was good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
What now? 185.
Down to a knee here. The defense still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them.